We know that the ACTCI has been a really instrumental tool with the comorbidity index. It has been an instrumental tool in evaluating the risk of non-relapse-related mortality among recipients of allogeneic hematopoietic cell transplantations. But it is important to note that the ACTCI was developed approximately 2 decades ago now, and the population that it was developed on, it does not really reflect the current transplant practice. Also, some of the comorbidities included there may not have the same impact. For instance, peptic ulcer disease in the early 2000s may have a more meaningful impact on outcomes of transplant when therapies were a bit different compared to today, which we typically just give PPIs and antibiotics if a H. pylori infection is observed. Our aim here was to develop and validate a score for non-relapse related mortality that could capture meaningful comorbidities. You know, if we summarize the rationale for that, we know that practice has changed over time. Second, in Memorial Sloan Kettering, where I practice, we typically use CD34 selected allogeneic transplants, and these were absent from the ACTCI development cohort. The third point for the rationale of the study is that there is a lot of variation in the ACTCI performance across different data sets. So we kind of wanted to see how it performs in our data and also see if there is a need to update it. What we did in the first phase, in the development phase, is take approximately 580 patients transplanted at Memorial Sloan Kettering with a CD34 selected transplant and analyze the impact of individual comorbidities on outcomes. What we found there is that the most meaningful comorbidities associated with outcomes were the pulmonary comorbidities, renal function, cardiac function, and hepatic disorders. We then incorporated these into a new score, which we call the Simplified Comorbidity Index, which builds on these comorbidities plus age. And we found that the new score, the SCI, it actually stratifies patients better with regard to non-relapse-related mortality compared to the ACTCI. We then went to validate the score in a different cohort from the Sheba Medical Center, where patients received unmodified graft, meaning these are non-CD34 selected transplant. And interestingly enough, we show that also it works well in a completely separate cohort. You know, if we need to summarize, we found that a small number of comorbidities are highly predictive of non-relapse-related mortality after CD34 selected allogeneic transplants. It should be noted that all transplants are performed in the development cohort with myeloablative conditioning. Second, we found that older age, cardiac dysfunction, pulmonary dysfunction, and liver and renal dysfunction together are as aggregated in the simplified comorbidity index, also can be used as a surrogate to predict NRM. And this was our non-relapse-related mortality. And we could show that both on our development cohort and in an external cohort.